guys in the parlor milking, one more in the barn bringing in cows and baking. So we're milking about 1,150 cows through here three times a day.
Hi there, I'm Dawn, and this is Promise. Here at Sun's Waking Up Farm, we found that one of the best ways to increase milk production in the dairy goats is to sing to them while you're milking. This here's a herd favorite. Just let your milk flow, like a good dairy goat. Let your milk flow, while you eat your oats. Just let your milk flow, and we'll fill up the pail. It's the reason. Just let your milk flow, you have so much to give. Just let your milk flow, you give me reason to live. Just let your milk flow, if you know what I mean. It's the season, it's the season, that's the reason. Let your milk flow. Well, I guarantee you, you sing to your goat while you're milking her, she'll appreciate the extra effort. And you and your family, you'll appreciate the extra milk.
Y'all are going to be milking, right? I just was getting her started. So wash her up, and then we get the first couple squirts out. Make sure there's nothing left in there that's old or anything that she drugged the teat across the ground and got anything in there. And then it's just a matter of, and we let the calf already have the other front one, so we only, it's kind of an odd, we get an uneven, it works much better when you have two hands going and you're in a rhythm. It's kind of hard to get one teat going. We typically milk this first one out and feed the other two calves off this teat, and then we take the two back ones, which gives us somewhere around 3.5 to 5 gallons a day of milk for us. So it's two milkings, so this morning we got about 2.5 gallons out of the back two. But we'll give it a shot.
Yeah, that back one seems, you definitely got to get a feel for that, I guess.
Yeah, it's just, it is, just getting in groove, you know, getting to know her and what makes it work. You want to make one work, doesn't make the other one work.
Empty already?
Yep.
Yeah, they drink it pretty fast.
The speed and agility and of the youth.
It's falling down.
My arms get hot.
About a half scoop.
Que los establos que tienen ordeñadores o cuidadores tranquilos y seguros tienen una mayor producción de leche. Por lo tanto, todo el personal debe de comportarse de una manera tranquila y controlada. Las mejores prácticas en la sala de ordeño incluyen varios factores. Las puertas y el equipo de contención o arreo deben operarse de manera cuidadosa, tranquila y segura. El tiempo de espera es minimizado en cada ordeña. La rutina de preparación que señala el inicio de la ordeña debe ser consistente y agradable para la vaca. La rutina incluye la revisión de la leche anormal y una exhaustiva limpieza y secado de los pezones. Las puntas de los pezones se revisan periódicamente para identificar algún problema. Se deben evitar las revisiones médicas o experiencias desagradables en el lugar de ordeño. La sala de espera en establos con sala de ordeño es el lugar donde se encuentra la mayor densidad animal del establo. Es importante que la prevención de lesiones sea considerada al diseñar el piso, el espacio, las paredes de la sala de espera y la entrada a la sala de ordeño. La regulación de temperaturas extremas usando ventiladores, aspersores u otras tecnologías aseguran el confort en la sala de espera y ordeño. Se le debe dar un mantenimiento periódico al equipo de ordeño y revisar el nivel de vacío y el número e intensidad de pulsaciones. También se revisa el equipo por si transmite toques de electricidad en caso de que se observe un comportamiento inusual o una disminución en la producción de leche. Para evitar la transmisión de enfermedades, se le debe dar un mantenimiento al equipo, además de lavarlo y desinfectarlo.
One time in the morning and later on. summer, so we try to keep a 12-hour rhythm. Your milk flow like a good dairy goat. Let your milk flow while you eat your oats. Just let your milk flow and we'll fill up the pail. It's the reason. Just let your milk flow. You have so much to give. Just let your milk flow. You give me reason to live, just let your milk flow. If you know what I mean, it's the season. It's the season, that's the reason, let your milk flow. Well, I guarantee you, you sing to your goat while you're milking her, she'll appreciate that extra effort.
So, this morning we got about 2.5 gallons out of the back too. But we'll give it a shot.
Yeah, that back one seemed, you definitely got to get a feel for that, I guess.
Yeah, it's just, it is, just getting in groove, you know, getting to know her and what makes it work. You want to make one work, doesn't make the other one work.
Empty already?
Yep. Yeah, they drink it pretty fast.
On the speed and agility and of the youth.
It's falling down.
Farms get hot.
About a half scoop.
Que los establos que tienen ordeñadores o cuidadores tranquilos y seguros tienen una mayor producción de leche. Por lo tanto, todo el personal debe de comportarse de una manera tranquila y controlada. Las mejores prácticas en la sala de ordeño incluyen varios factores. Las puertas y el equipo de contención o arreo deben operarse de manera cuidadosa, tranquila y segura. El tiempo de espera es minimizado en cada ordeña. La rutina de preparación que señala el inicio de la...
milking about 1,150 cows through here three times a day.
Hi there, I'm Dawn, and this is Promise. Here at Sun's Waking Up Farm, we've found that one of the best ways to increase milk production in your dairy goats is to sing to them while you're milking. This here's a herd favorite. And you and your family, you'll appreciate the extra milk.
Y'all are going to be milking, right? I just was getting her started. So wash her up, and then we get the first couple squirts out. Make sure there's nothing left in there that's old or anything that she drugged the teat across the ground and got anything in there. And then it's just a matter of, and we let the calf already have the other front one, so we only, it's kind of an odd. We get an uneven, it works much better when you have two hands going and you're in a rhythm. It's kind of hard to get one teat going. We typically milk this first one out and feed the other two calves off this teat, and then we take the two back ones, which gives us somewhere around 3.5 to 5 gallons a day of milk for us. So it's two milkings.